During the Second World War, Churchill had a secret army of people, and they were called the Auxiliars, or what was the other name for them? The English Resistance. Churchill's secret army. We call it the Churchill secret army. And they were trained at a place called Coleshill, which is not far from where I live. They were specially selected individuals, and they were generally people in reserved occupations, so that they weren't called up, but they were specially trained. If there was ever an invasion, their job was to disrupt the enemy as much as possible. And they had a pretty hard task to do. And they had an estimated lifespan that if it had gone wrong, their estimated lifespan was 10 days. Anyway, Coleshill was where they were trained. They were sent to, once they were selected, they were sent to the post office in Highworth, where they met a lady called Mrs. Stranks, who then told them where to go, and they had to go to Coleshill. Coleshill's got an open day today, so we're going to have a look. The secret bunker's there, I believe, and other bits and pieces going on, so it'll be interesting. Certainly be interesting for me anyway. I hope you'll join me. My wife is. I recognise that horse. Oh, no, they'll be up here.
Have a good day.
So apparently, along here is where the bunker is. There's something we've got happening over there. Is that the bunker over there?
This is the way if you want to go down the operational bay.
Yeah, I'm not okay to do some filming, am I?
Yeah.
And the lookout.
Areas
over there, so it's basically a big hole where they
have a look up the area. This is the lookout area, apparently. It's normally been covered over. So that would have been covered over, that would have been their lookout. Well, the original bunker apparently is about a mile up that way, but they've got a replica bunker here which we can look in.
Put that down
the right directions.
So I can go down there? I'm filming.
You can go down there, yes.
Yeah, and then this down and through, is it?
Down and through, and there's a guy called Roger who we're meeting.
Okay.
If you can use the side of the ladder.
Yeah, okay.
Can we look at my
lobby? Oh, quite a narrow gap. Hello there.
Some of the work fans didn't bother coming out, did they?
Some of them have backed out because they found it a bit difficult.
It's a bit boring, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes, that's fine, thank you.
I'll see you in the middle. Wow! Oh.
Marvellous.
When you make your way out, just be careful because it's sharp. If you stand too soon, you're going to hurt yourself. Yeah. But that's half the length of the normal tunnel. We made it shorter just for safety's sake. And what you see on the table, they're just replicas, they're not real grenades, by the way. It's not a real knife, you all. You'll see all those down in the granary. They've got a very good display. Sorry?
The purpose was a supply was, or?
Yeah, no, it's a hideaway, basically.
Yeah.
So they get the call sign over the radio. That we're being invaded. They walk out and disappear.
Thank you. Cheers.
Hello.
Very good.
Thank you.
Hi there.
Hello.
Oh, it's raining.
I know.
Oh,
it's really cold, isn't it? It's nice.
So now you know where the entrance is. Look. There you go. It's interesting, yeah. Yeah, so that outline of the hedge there, that is where Coleshill House stood.
Yes, in the front entrance. So see where the notice
that's
the house,
yeah.
That's the front entrance looking down that way.
Okay.
It's very, very small, but when you look at the picture of the room, I just have it.
Stable door, but I don't think I've got one in here.
Remains of Coleshill House.
Together. What you do here, there's a file of acid in there, and there's also a taut spring and a lead, right? And what happens is you squeeze that with a pair of pliers, the acid eats through the lead, that releases the spring, goes down and hits a cap on the end of there, bang. Now two of them, because again they're affected by temperature. So although they were colour-coded, it's worn off a bit now on this one, as opposed to anything from like half an hour to 2 days. And you'd have a pack
it off with, because you do not want to be there when it does go off.
So, now different ways of setting things like this off. I've got different types of booby traps in here. This, for example, is a pressure switch in that you can see a spindle through there. Right, you put the peg out, put it in there, this goes, there's a cap in there, and there, when that is broken by pressure, it releases the spring, that hits the cap, the fuse, bang. Okay, that's one method. Other methods, this is a pull switch, which you can nail into a tree or something like that. Again, you've inserted the fuse there, go into the explosives there, you've stretched it across the an opening, pulls that, releases it, hits cap, bang. That's that method. This is over 70 years old, this one, is a lift switch. It's a pressure release. I shan't do it because it's a bit on the fragile side. The way that works is this is pulled back to there, closed. Where that hole is there, again, you've got the fuse going bang. So when whatever's on top of that is taken off, it springs open, hits the cap.
This is normally private, so the only time we have access to come up through the site of Coleshill House is because historically it is part of the tenancy of the clockhouse, is when I'm doing a guided walk, which I do once a month or on demand, or when we have an odd day like this day. But I just point you here because you can just see, you know, if you did have the garden and those trees, you would have had a fabulous view across here. And if you look to the wind turbine, that's West Mill Wind Farm. To the right of the wind turbine, there's a building. What does it look like, Ed? So a folly just means it's built on a whim, really. Oh, do you know what? I really fancy a ruined castle in my grounds. Let's go and build one. So that's what's happened there. So the front of it looks like a castle, and if you go behind it,
so behind me is the location of the original Coleshill house, which was destroyed by fire completely. But we've been told if we follow the arrows, right, we come to the original operations base, which is 75 years old.
Yeah, I was playing in my own about that. So. Right. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Right. So welcome to this operations base. I mean, this it's been on telly a few times, this particular base, because in the last few years there's been an awful lot more interest about the underground resistance that was set up in the event of German invasion. So we think this structure dates from 1942. We thought it was possibly the earliest one on the site, so it was used for training the auxiliars who come to Coleshill to learn skills in underground resistance. But just recently, we found another structure about 100 yards over that way, which is a kind of more primitive version of this, being just a sort of square pit in the ground with a wooden frame with corrugated sheets over it. This is more sophisticated, so could be a sort of slightly later version. So 1942, we think. So it was used for training people who would then take those skills back into other bits of the countryside, you know, where they could disseminate those skills and actually then develop their own bunkers with these sort of principles. So the idea is you've probably got, I think it's 8 men who'd be underground here. So if the Germans invade, their role is not full-on confrontation. What they're trying to do is carry out acts of sabotage and also intelligence. So what they want to be doing is attacking communication lines, telephone lines, things like that. They're not actually trying to, as I say, carry out a sort of full-on sort of confrontation. And the idea is that they could have been underground for up to 2 weeks. The stores and supplies they'd have had would allow them to be up to 2 weeks underground. And so this bit is the main sort of chamber where they would have been. And the actual entry is just behind these brick walls here. So these two brick walls were added slightly later, and these are blast walls, because the idea is that if the Germans discovered people underground, the first thing that they do is just chuck a grenade down the access hatch. So the blast walls are supposed to stop the impact of the grenade. I suspect in reality the shot coming through wouldn't, they would have been killed anyway, but it's to give them a bit more protection. And then the door at the other end, you have to bear in mind that the actual structure was a tunnel going out much further to the boundary wall, and they then had this hatch in the wall that would allow them to escape. So if the Germans are trying to focus there, they'd give them maybe 5 or 10 minutes to try and get out across the park. So this is the main bit that they're occupying. Interestingly, I mean, you've got a floor here with some drainage. The actual original floor level would have been at this height, so you'd have had a wooden slatted floor coming across. Interestingly, anyone got any thoughts on this grill here?
Remains of a bed, perhaps.
It's a bed, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it was hinged from here. So you'd probably had four men sleeping at any one time. The others are carrying out you know, sort of observation work, repairing equipment, things like that. So they were in shifts. There is evidence here, they had a kitchen, so they had a cooker here, and you can see some of the fittings where it was attached to the wall, probably cupboards here. There's a hole in the wall here, which is for the flue, for the cooker, to take any fumes from the cooker. And up on the top, you may see there's a little tin fitting, which that flue went up through a hollow chimney, so they're trying to hide the smoke and things like that. You also need a loo, so the little bit on this side would have been a chemical toilet. So they've got a chemical loo here, and they've got a little chimney that runs up through that to take the fumes out. The little room in there was the stores room, so you've had all your food, all your air conditioning, your radios and things like that.
Oh, there is
so,
a ladder. Well,
there
is. Yes, there is. There's a light there. Say hello.
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 They're not actually in square frames, they taper at an angle. And the idea of that is that...
That's the other entrance to the bunker.
I can do it!
Turn and check.